Hey there, CyberSakhi here. Previously, we saw how hashing detects tampering of messages unless Joker changes the hash of the message itself. Today, we'll see how to prevent that from happening.
Remember in the last video we saw, hashing alone can't solve everything. You send a message to the bank. To prove that the message hasn't been tampered with, you also send a hash of the ciphertext along with the actual message. The idea was for the bank to calculate the hash of the ciphertext on their end and match it with the hash of the ciphertext that you send. If the hash is matched, then the message wasn't tampered with. But we also saw that this was a very bad practice of proving integrity. If Joker can modify the ciphertext, he can also generate a new hash of the modified ciphertext and send that along. The bank thinks that everything is good because when they calculate the hash of the ciphertext, it matches with the hash that they received from the Joker. So how do we ensure that the hash itself can't be forged by Joker? Let's dive into authenticity. In security, authenticity means being sure that the person or the system who sent the message is really who they claim to be. In short, you are who you say you are. Authenticity is about trusting the source of the message. Some trust that proves that the message came from the legitimate source. In the last video, we tried to attempt integrity of a message by hashing it. But integrity without authenticity is useless. We need a method to prove not just that the message is unchanged, but also that the hash is created by the legitimate sender. Let's learn about HMAC. HMAC stands for Hash-Based Message Authentication Code. It's basically hashing, where we mix a secret key into the hashing process. The secret ingredient or secret key is known only to the sender and the receiver. We have already learned how we can securely exchange keys using asymmetric cryptography in our previous video on asymmetric encryption. So we can assume that the sender and receiver were able to exchange this shared secret key securely. Now coming to HMAC, imagine blending fruits for the hash as before, but you now also add a special secret ingredient. By adding the secret ingredient, the smoothie's color and taste change dramatically. And so, without that ingredient, the final flavor can't be matched. If Joker intercepts an HMAC protected message, he might flip bits in the ciphertext. But then he'll also need the secret to recompute a valid HMAC. Since he doesn't know the secret, no amount of guessing will help. The tampered HMAC won't match, and the receiver knows something is up. Let us see this in action with our previous example. CyberSakhi sends a message, "Hey bank, give Sam $100. She encrypts it with a session key. Then using a shared secret, known only to her and the bank, she computes an HMAC of that encrypted message. Joker intercepts this logged message, tries flipping some bits, and then attempts to recalculate the hash. But he doesn't have the secret key, so he cannot produce the correct hash or the HMAC. And when the bank calculates the hash of the ciphertext using the secret key, they know it is incorrect and discard the modified message. Let's do a quick HMAC demo in the terminal. Under the hood, HMAC uses the same hash functions like SHA-256 or MD5. It just does some extra steps involving the secret key. If you have followed our previous videos on hashing, you know how to compute hash of a text with SHA-256 or MD5, but HMAC involves some extra steps using the secret key. First, let's see what happens when we use HMAC with SHA-256 on a simple message. I'm going to use hello as our message and secret as our key, as our secret key. As you see, the output is the HMAC of our message using SHA-256. Now watch what happens when I change just one letter in our message from capital H to small h, or change the key slightly. This will show how sensitive HMAC is to any changes in the input or the key. You see the HMAC changes dramatically. Similarly, if we try to change the secret key, again, HMAC is just so different. So this is crucial for security because it prevents any tampering without detection. Now, to understand the importance of using a key, let's compare this to a non-HMAC message of the same message. You see, this is just so different from any of the HMACs that we computed, which involve the secret key.
So that wraps up our HMAC demo. We all saw that HMAC is incredibly important to know that the message came from a legit source and it wasn't tampered with. So this makes it incredibly valuable for secure communications. Thanks for tuning in. If you all like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. If you have any questions or if you want to see more such demos, please leave a comment below. Till then, stay secure and I'll see you all in the next video.